Hi, I'm Susan Taylor with Scripps Health in San Diego, California. 37.3 million Americans are living with diabetes. This is according to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. Managing this condition is not easy. Eating a special diet, getting enough exercise, measuring your blood sugar levels, taking medication. But in addition, there can be a lot of mental health issues that come with living with diabetes. Joining us to talk about this is Dr. Karla Espinosa de los Monteros. She is a clinical health psychologist who leads the Diabetes Behavior Health Integration Program at the Scripps Whittier Diabetes Institute, providing psychological support to people living with diabetes. Doctor, thanks so much for being with us.
Thanks for having me.
So how does diabetes affect the way you think and feel about yourself?
That's a really great question. I think to really understand how it makes people feel, we have to consider the way that we talk and think about diabetes as a society. So most people are under the impression that when people get diagnosed with diabetes, it's because they didn't take care of themselves. And so when people first get diagnosed, a lot of times there's a lot of guilt, shame that comes with the diagnosis, which can make, you know, the whole experience even more difficult for the person.
And it even affects the way you talk to yourself?
Yeah. So it's actually one of the most common things that I see in people who come in to see me is a lot of that negative self-talk. So people coming in and saying, you know, I should know better. There's something wrong with me. There's a lot of apologizing for them struggling to get their diabetes to a safe place. And I think that comes from a lot of that stigma, that belief that you kind of caused this, you created this problem, and now people feel like somehow there's something wrong with them for continuing to struggle with this.
So talk about the stress of having diabetes, of having a chronic illness.
Well, diabetes is no easy thing to live with. And the reason it's really hard is because we ask a lot of our patients. So in order to manage diabetes, you really have to be thinking about it on a regular basis. Every time you sit down to eat, you have to think about what you are eating. Every time you get up in the morning, you have to check your blood sugar. Oftentimes people are doing that multiple times a day. You have to take medication lots of times a day for some people, sometimes just once a day, but either way, you know, not very pleasant, especially if there's side effects or, you know, you're doing injections, which has, you know, it's a whole other beast right there. It is, you know, having to think about every day, all the time, about how you're doing. It's kind of like getting graded every single day and maybe often not getting that grade that you want. So learning to live with the grays and things not being perfect, that can be really hard for people. Not to mention that we don't live in a world that's diabetes friendly. And so you're living and navigating in environments where you're constantly going to be around things that maybe you're trying to avoid or around people who don't understand the challenges of living with diabetes. So it can be really difficult in that way. And then there's also the part that we are, you know, anyone living with diabetes is human just like the rest of us and has all the other stressors that they have to deal with in their lives, whether it's work or family or children they need to take care of. And so they're doing that and dealing with the diabetes can be quite a challenge.
And stress and anxiety can actually raise your blood sugar levels. Is that correct?
That is true, that stress and anxiety can affect blood sugar. And it does that to all of us, not just people with diabetes. It's just that people with diabetes are the ones that have to then deal with the aftermath of that because it affects their management. And it can be quite frustrating for people, especially because, you know, a lot of times if it's stress, it's not anything you're doing. It's not what you ate. It's not what you did necessarily. You know, you might've exercised, you might've done all those things, but your diabetes is still not where it needs to be. And that can be really difficult. And of course there's no living your life without stress. And so this is something that is a very real challenge that people with diabetes have to struggle with sometimes.
Talk about diabetes distress. What is that? And how do you deal with it?
Diabetes distress is a term that we use to describe a set of symptoms that people who are living with diabetes often present with. And they can look a lot like depression. In fact, oftentimes it is misdiagnosed as depression in people. But the difference here is that when people are feeling down or hopeless or discouraged or overwhelmed, the reason they're feeling that way is because it's because of the diabetes. Whereas when you're depressed, it might be a more global thing. Like, I just generally feel hopeless, or I generally feel down. In the case of somebody who's dealing with diabetes stress, they feel that way when they think about their diabetes, or they feel that way when their blood sugar is not where it needs to be, or after they went to see a doctor and got bad news.
Talk about the BeHIP program at the Scripps Whittier Diabetes Institute.
Yeah, so that stands for the Diabetes Behavioral Health Integration Program. And it is a wonderful program we have here at Scripps, where we have psychologists that are literally embedded in the clinic with our diabetes and endocrinology team. And what that allows us to do is that when patients come in and they present with any challenges that would require mental health support, we're able to come in right away and see patients oftentimes during the same visit. And then we're also able to work in consultation with our doctors to help provide the patient the support they need to get to where they want to be in regards to their diabetes.
So if somebody with diabetes is experiencing these mental health challenges, if they're stressed or they're anxious, depressed, if they're being very self-critical, what should they do?
First of all, I would tell the person that they're not alone, that living with diabetes is incredibly hard, and their reaction is understandable given the amount of stress that comes with diabetes. And then I would say, come talk to us. And, you know, that's what we're here for. We're here to help support you. And the best way to do that is just to ask your primary care doctor or your endocrinologist for a referral to our clinic.
If you don't get a handle on this, what can happen long-term?
I think that the biggest problem for, you know, that I see is that if you don't address this, it's going to make your experience of living with diabetes so much harder than it has to be. And that over time could get in the way of you being able to get to where you need to be safe. And so, you know, this is already hard enough as it is. You don't have to go through this alone. It can absolutely get better with some support. And so there's no need to wait until like you're so burned out that you're over it. Come talk to us and we'll help support you.
Any final thoughts, doctor?
Yeah. So just going back to what we talked about at the beginning with stigma, I think it's really important to remind people that while lifestyle definitely impacts your risk for diabetes, it is absolutely not the only reason why people get diabetes. There's a huge genetic component there that you didn't get to choose. And so it's really important that you're kind to yourself. Like, if I can ask people to do anything, it's just be kind to yourself. This is hard. And if you're struggling, don't hesitate to get support. It can definitely get better.
Doctor, thanks so much for being with us. We appreciate you taking the time.
Thank you, Susan.
If you want more information on dealing with the mental health issues that are related to diabetes, just click on the link or go to scripps.org/videos. Want more critical information about your health? Please subscribe to our Scripps Health YouTube channel and follow us on social media at Scripps Health. At Scripps, we're here for good. I'm Susan Taylor. Thanks for joining us.